Good evening and welcome to another edition of Friday Night Lights. I'm Jay Pushkar, he's Tom Decker, and Mike Fenner has the night off. And Tom, plenty of playoff action tonight, including four high school football games to have note.
Yeah, and while there were three District 10 championship games on Friday night slate, the Cathedral Prep Ramblers continued their postseason march with another Class 5A sub-regional.
And for that one, we'll go to Central Cambria High School, where the Ramblers faced Hollidaysburg, and we'll pick it up in the first quarter of play. Ramblers already leading 7-0 when Michael Parks III bursts through and scores. Prep leading 14-0. Ramblers on the move again. But the drive is going to stall when Luke Costello's pass to DeMario Crawford is completed. But then the ball gets stripped and the Golden Tigers recover. After nothing doing, Prep back on offense. Costello finds Crawford for the touchdown. Ramblers leading 21-0. Later in the first half, Costello finds Damarian Bridger for another score. That one's the big dagger right there. And it's Cathedral Prep blowing out Hollidaysburg 48-7. The Ramblers improving to 9-1 on the season.
Meadville General McLean meeting up at Edinburgh University for the District 10 Class 4A Championship. Lancers came out fast. This is Dylan Sheeter. He's running the option. He keeps it and scores. Lancers take an early 7-0 lead. Meadville would answer right back. Look at this run by Kalon Simmons. Starts out to the right, cuts back left. I mean, this kid has got moves on top of moves, breaks a tackle there. He's finally going to put it into the end zone as the Dogs make it 8-6 after the successful two-point conversion. But back comes General McLean. John Amon, he's going to run the keeper this time, and he's going to keep it himself. Lancers go back in front 13-8. Let's go to the second quarter now. Meadville starts to open things up. Simmons muscling his way in for his second score. That made it 16-13 Dogs. And more from Meadville and more from Simmons. This time it's the sweep, and again, he marches into the end zone untouched. 24-13, Meadville. Later in that quarter, Meadville continuing to pour it on. Simmons on that sweep. Again, they love that play, and again, he would score. Boy, Meadville looked good in this one. They take home the championship as they down the Lancers 52-19. The Class A championship was on the line at Greenville High School as Cochranton met up with Reynolds. In the first, it's Reynolds' Jalen Wagner. He takes the handoff, finds a hole, and he is gone. The Raiders getting on the board early in this one. They take the early 7-0 lead. Cardinals offense, well, it struggled tonight. Noah Cummings can't handle the snap. The Raiders are there to recover the ball, and then they get going from there. More on the ground again. It's Wagner. Finds himself in the open field, and he scores again. Reynolds, they give Cochranton its first loss of the season and end that season. They take this one 23-0.
Meanwhile, on the high school football scoreboard, Farrell rolls to the District 10 Class 2A championship by routing Wilmington 48-6. It was a down-to-the-final-four scenario in the PSAC men's and women's soccer tournament as Mercers and Gannon had both teams battling for conference championships, hopefully by weekend's end. At Saxon Stadium we go for the Lakers taking on Millersville. Early on in a scoreless match, Mercers awarded a free kick and Dylan Sumner's shot is easily saved. Minutes later, the Lakers back on the attack. Nick Munch rockets one on net, but the save is made again. Closing minutes of the first half, and the Marauders would score off the free play from the corner. Rebound opportunity for Richie Valverde. He gets the goal. Millersville goes on to shut out Mercyhurst 2-0. In the other PSAC semifinal, Gannon taking on Lockhaven. The Knights grabbing a 1-0 lead just minutes into the contest, and then their defense simply took over, not to mention they got a break here or there. Lockhaven thought that they had the tying goal, but they were ruled offsides. Lockhaven now on a corner kick, and Connor Swope tries the header, but Max Rocco is there for the save as he was brilliant between the pipes. He would post a clean sheet in this one as Gannon able to knock off Lockhaven. Another nice save there by the visitors. It's Gannon advancing to the PSAC final. They beat Lockhaven 1-0. In women's soccer, both Mercyhurst and Gannon fell in the conference semifinals. Lakers losing to Bloomsburg 2-0, and the Knights losing to Millersville 1-0. The Penn State Barren women's soccer team continues their postseason run when they face Wesleyan in the first round of the NCAA Division III tournament on Saturday. This year's Lions team already has the most wins in a season in program history, and they are riding a 15-game winning streak into the match. For the AMCC champs, they hope this magical season just keeps on going.
I think our collective play has improved, and I think individual players, when they come here generally, like they show a progression in their play, and I think that's happened for a lot of them this year. So we're happy about that, yeah. I just remind the players that there's a reason we're 19-1, and yeah, our opponent's 14-1-2, but we have some really good players as part of our program, so we have to do some things to adapt to them.
I think we've improved a lot. We came in the season in really good shape, which helped us out a lot, but we were able to tactically build ourselves up and just get a lot better at connecting passes and moving forward with the ball.
What kind of confidence are you guys riding right now?
I think we have a lot of confidence. Usually we go into the national tournament just happy to be there, but we know we're a force to reckon with now, and we're ready to go in and work really hard.
And Tom, a pair of local women's basketball teams made their regular season home debuts this afternoon and evening.
Yeah, including the Penn State Nittany Lions, I guess you would say. Strike up the band at the Junker Center. We're going to pick up the action in the first. Kara Hazlett, she's going to take the defender off the dribble, and she knocks down the jumper. Then with time winding down in the first, Hazlett, she's going to get the pass at the wing, and she buries a three. Barron leading 25-20 after one. She finished with 23 points. The Kangaroos trying to keep pace. And boy, Kennedy Allen gives it to the Seattle Latau for three. That's good. Then SUNY Canton cashes in. Another trip, another bucket. Barron, though, they're going to kick it up a notch. Elena Dibble to Brianna Dean, and that bucket is good in the paint. Lions rolling this one 91-60. Edinburgh making its home debut against Bluefield State for the Big Blue. Aza Rhea Binford with the drive and the bucket. She had a team-high 15 points. At the other end, it's Haley Sims for the Scots, and she's going to bury that corner three. She poured in a game-high 24 points. And then how about Ashton Boggs? She's going to net two of her 12 points. Edinburgh looked good. It's their regular season home opener, and they topple Bluefield 72-60. On to the men's college basketball scoreboard now. At Shepherd University, Mercyhurst rolls past Bowie State 96-56. The Lakers were led offensively by Steve Kennedy and Micah McIntosh with 17 points each. Mercyhurst faces Fayetteville State on Saturday afternoon.
Meanwhile, as for the Edinburgh men's basketball team, Pat Cleary's program begins its season on the road tomorrow at Fairmont State. And like the women's team, the Fighting Scots had their entire season wiped out last year because of the pandemic. However, getting back on the court and competing once again is already a highlight for them going into the 2021-22 season.
To have it taken from us last year, I think it put a lot of value back into what we do. I think that, you know, the guys really, really see the opportunity that's there now. In the past, it was just kind of what they did. Now they can see the value in it.
We got a lot of young guys that are hungry. We got a lot of older guys that are hungry. We brought in a lot of upperclassmen in that have experience in the PSAC, two D1 transfers. So we're just very excited to mix all that in and show what we can do.
I think we're going to play very fast. I think we're going to be a very fast transition team. You know, we're going to play a lot of five out, and I feel like we're going to exploit a lot of mismatches. So I think we're going to be a very exciting team. We're just going to be showtime this year.